asking me, do I have a kingdom? I'm the one that has come. As a matter of fact, he told them, my kingdom is not of this world. Yeah. If it were of this world, then would my servants fight that I should not be delivered unto the Jews. But my kingdom is not from here. If you want to know, am I a king? He said, well, this reason was I born. That's why I came into the world. Yeah. As a matter of fact, the angel said in Luke 1:32-33, he said unto the woman, said that which is conceived of you is of the Holy Ghost. And this holy thing that shall be born of you shall be called the Son of God. He shall say amen if you care. Let's look at that in first, that is Luke 1:31-33, because he gave a prediction, and the angel said that he would be the one that would rule over the kingdom. Somebody said, why you stand over that? Because the kingdom and the church were used interchange. Say amen. When I'm talking about the kingdom, I'm talking about the church. When I'm talking about the church, I'm talking about the kingdom. Yeah. Somebody said, well, why do you talk on the kingdom so much? Because the kingdom, you can't be saved unless you know something about the kingdom. Say amen. Now the Bible says, behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, bring forth a son, shall call his name Jesus. Read on, and he shall be called great, called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. Next verse, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Say amen. Somebody said, wait just a minute, Brother Foster. Back to the Bible I go. I want you to know that the church of Christ is the original church. Yes, it's all of them, these denominations and these answers. All of them, the Catholic Church. Catholic Church 303-606. Church of Christ was already here in Jerusalem around about AD 33. Say amen. It's the oldest church. All of them, the Muslim faith. And Muhammad wasn't born until 17th to the 8th century. And the kingdom came about in around about 700 and something. But then things went on. All of these denominational churches, all of them came for man. But the original church was the kingdom he said he would be. Somebody said, well, wait just a minute. What did he say, and where is it used interchangeably? Matthew 16:18-19. The Bible says over there, I want you to see it in your Bibles. This is where he said that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I'll build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatsoever thou shalt bind in heaven will be on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever thou shalt bind in heaven will be bound on earth. In other words, heaven and earth were working together. And the kingdom and the church were used interchangeably. When you're talking about one, you're talking about the other. Somebody said, well, could you define the kingdom as the reign of God? Yes, he's reigning, because it takes four things to have a kingdom. You got to have, number one, you got to have some subjects. Number two, you got to have a king. Number three, you got to have a territory. And number four, you got to have a law. Say amen. Can you all say amen? You got to have that. Now the king works in the heart, because that's where he rules. Somebody said, well, who has that authority? Daniel 7:13-14. Daniel said, and I saw in the night vision, behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven, came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him, and there was given him dominion, glory, and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve. His kingdom is an everlasting kingdom which shall not pass away, and his dominion that which shall not pass. Now wait a minute, he's got the authority, he has the rule. Jesus, he's got the authority. Say amen. Somebody say, how much does he have? Well, I'll let you see in Ephesians 1:20. The Bible says, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead, set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above all principality, power, might, and dominion, and every name that's named, not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. And it put all things under his feet, gave him to be the head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all. That's one reason I'm a member of the church. It's the original church. It's the only blood-bought church that you can find in the Bible. Acts 20:28. Take heed therefore unto yourselves and over the flock, over the which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers, and feed the church of God, which he purchased with his own blood. Say amen. So the Bible is right. Somebody came on campus there during the lectureship looking for my books, and from one of my books, and said, nah, there's some other books out there, but we want yours because you talk more about the church. Amen. The one church than any of the books that have been written by our brother. And that was a compliment. I'm going to send him several of them about the one church. Say amen. Amen. And so the Bible is right. Well, I'm getting ready to close here. Number four, Pilate offered the people a choice, trying to clear himself so he could reject Jesus. He asked his men around, said, you know, there's a custom, and here's a point. That is, we have nothing written from the law of the Jews, that is the old covenant, where this was ever done in Passover, that one would be offered. This is something that may have come out of the Greeks or the Romans, but he said, now you know you have a law. It's a custom that you would let one go, and the other one would be put to death. So he's dealing with that, and he, to help me out here, Brother Thompson, you and Brother McDaniel, come up here and help me out to demonstrate this. And so you got two men. I'm closing. I'm not going to do anything to them now. You wise. They just happened to me to do an illustration, don't you see? All right. Now, so here it is. Pilate, watch how he's handling it. And what he wants, he says, now, isn't it true? So he wouldn't have to commit himself. He thought that if he could pull up the matter, and now both of you good men now, I got to look at you. Both of you mighty good men. I love both of you dearly, but somebody got to be my murderer. So, hey, all right, Brother Thompson volunteered. All right, so he's Barabbas, you see, and this is the Christ. So what he did, he sat down in the dungeon to bring up out of the prison a man that was a notable criminal, a murderer, an evildoer, which was Barabbas. And then he thought that if he could have brought him up, then the people, it wouldn't have been any issue with their selecting Christ to live. See, and to put Barabbas, because they knew he was a murderer. And so he was trying to clear his hand. He's already washed his hands, trying to say that I'm innocent, but you can't have it both ways. Now he brings the murderer up, put him up before the Son of God, bring them out, and say, now which of the twin do you want me to release so that they would make the decision? Don't you see? And here it is. It was no comparison. Here is the wonderful counselor. Mighty God, everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Don't you see? Here is an old murderer condemned to die, and he was guilty. This man that was no fault finding, never did any sins at all. The sinless, the spotless Lamb of God. Which of the twain? They cried out, I want you to let Barabbas go free. But with Jesus, I want you to crucify him. Crucify. Let this man go free. They made a choice to crucify Jesus and let this man go free. Pilate, to save himself, thank you so much, brethren, took the Christ thing and said, so that I could stand with the people and with Caesar, and had him scourged. They beat him 1 inch from his death. Then he brought him out, probably dripping in blood. Crown of thorns on his brow. When he came out, he said, behold the man. Look at your man. And zap the man you call your king. Look at your man. All beaten down. Jesus came, not saying a mumbling word. Where you going, Christ? I'm not too strong now. They beat me all through the night. But I gotta take the cross now. up to the summit of the hill. Yes, I'm going to go home, but I'm not going to say a mumbling word. They put the cross on his back. He's going up the summit now, walking the cobblestones. Where you going, Christ? I'm going with the cross to bear the sins of the world. Who has believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? He shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of a dry ground. He had no form nor comeliness. When we should see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep had gone astray, turned everyone to his own way. But the Lord has laid upon him the iniquities of us all. Say amen if you can. Son of the living God, he went up there and died for the sins of the world. Say amen. Oh, my friends, it may have been. Now, you won't find this. This is just deductive reasoning that Pilate's wife may have been in that group from Pentecost. We don't know. About 3,000 obeyed. Say amen. We do know this much, that she believed that he was the sinless Christ. Say amen. Have nothing to do with this just man. But history shows old Pilate ended up committing suicide. There he had every opportunity. God was right before him, but he wouldn't accept the blessing that was right in front of his eyes. My friend, if you're here and you know you need to come, what a great opportunity. The world has been talking about Thanksgiving, but Thanksgiving is thanksgiving. It's every day. We couldn't put one foot in front of the other without the Jesus, without Christ. Thank you, some of us. You know, sometimes you talk to some of us. Some of us will tell you, I ate so many black eyed peas yesterday. Oh, Joe's and ham. Say amen. Oh, I was all on the table. Say amen. Come on, I already know. Say amen. But at the same time, it was the Lord that provided. The Lord blessed us to put one foot in front of the other and come in any day. It ought to be thank you, Jesus, every day. Say amen. Here and you know you need to come. We invite you to come. He said, you're my friends if you do whatsoever I've commanded you. He said, a man that will have friends must show himself friendly. And there is a friend that sticketh closer than me. Say amen. We believe that to be Jesus. And he said, you are my friends if you do whatsoever I have commanded you to do. What did he command us to do? Hear and believe the word. John 5:24, we got to do it, you know, Brother Raw, you know, in Hobbs, in Mexico out there, we need this all over the world where people will preach the gospel and tell people what to do to be saved. Say amen. Amen. And Jesus said, he that heareth these words of mine and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life, and is not coming to condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. So you got to hear and you got to believe. That. Why? Because he commanded. You are my friends if you do whatsoever I have commanded you. And then he commanded that we would repent. According to Acts 17:30-31, in the time of this ignorance, God went that but now commanded all men everywhere to repent. What did he do? Commanded everyone everywhere to repent. It's a commandment. And then we must not only repent, but we must confess. Acts 8:37, the man made the confession, I believe, that's the man from Africa, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And then Acts 8:38, they commanded the church to stand still. They both went down into the water, and when they would come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord called away Philip. You saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing. Say amen. Amen. So God put confession in the plan of salvation. And then baptism is commanded. How do you know? Bible says in Matthew 28:18, he came and spake unto them, saying, all power in heaven and earth hath been given unto me. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always, even unto the end of the world. Teaching them ought to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I've commanded you. What did he just command? Go teach and baptize. Say amen. Baptism is a command. If you are my friends, if you do whatsoever I've commanded you. What did he command? Hear, believe, repent, confess, and be baptized. Amen. So if you're here, we're asking you to come from all over this audience, and we're asking you to come right now while we stand and sing the song.
They tried, my Lord.